virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshada Kale and today we will learn maths. Okay, now we will move to the chapter. Today we will learn maths of standard 3rd and name of the chapter is division. Dear children, this is part 1. Okay? Yes. What is the meaning of division? Division is an operation in maths. You know the different operations like addition, subtraction and multiplication. Isn't it? This is the 4th type of operation that is called as division. Yes, dear children, whenever you want to find out the total, you go for addition, right? Whenever you want to find out the difference between the numbers, you use subtraction method, right? And how many times the same thing repeated, if then you go for multiplication. Now this is 4th type of operation. In this, whenever we need the distribution, that is equal distribution we want to do, then we go for division. Okay, now in this chapter we will study about the division in detail. First we will go through a story. Okay, a story of 12 delicious apples. Fresh and delicious apples. How many? 12 are there. Okay, you can see here 12 red, delicious, fresh apples. Okay, this we want to distribute among these children. Okay, they are very happy because they know that they will get apples. Now here we will count how many children are there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. There are 12 children. Okay, we will start distribution of apple. Okay, I will give first 1, 1 to each one. Here, see this. We will give 1 apple to each child. And we will see how many apples will be left. Yes. Okay. Now there are 12 apples and 12 children. So each child will get 1 apple, isn't it? Here we can say we made an equal distribution of the apples we had, so that each child got 1 apple, correct? Now same apples are there, and how many children we will see here? 1, 2. Only 2 children are there, and now we have to distribute these apples equally between these 2 children. Okay, one thing we will do, let us give 1 apple to each. Take this. Here one we will give to this boy, this to girl, this one to boy, again to the girl, again to this boy, to the girl, to this boy, to the girl and to the boy. Yes, this is last for this girl and this is also last for this boy. Yes, here there are no more apples left, isn't it? So we will count how many apples she got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Yes, if we distribute these 12 apples among these two, then Mona will get 6 apples. Isn't it? And what about this one? He also will get 6 apples. What is his name? Raj. Raj too will get 6 apples because 6 are there. Got this? When we distribute 12 delicious apples between two children, the each child will get 6 apples. Right? Very good. Same story here. A story of 12 delicious apples. 12 apples we can see here. We will try to distribute these apples among these three children. Okay? Let us start the distribution. See here, one for this girl, one for this boy, and one for the third boy. Again, here, second round is going on. Yes. Third round we will give. Yes. Now again three remains. So, we can give one. Right? Yes. Means, if we distribute these 12 apples among three students, then each one will get how many? Each one will get 4 apples. Isn't it? Yes, see, among three means they will get 4 apples. Right? Again, here 12 delicious apples are there. And how many children are there? 4. Okay, 4 children are there. Now, we have to distribute these 12 apples among these 4 children. We will see how many they will get. Okay, we will start our distribution from 1. First round is over. Now we start the second round. Each one has received 2. Now third round. Yes. Now no more apples in here. Correct? No more apples left. So we can see here each one will get 3 apples. Correct? Now here we can see the equal distribution of the 12 apples. So we can write here, each child will get 3 apples. Correct? Now, again here, these apples are there. Now, let us try to distribute among 6 children. See here, 3, 6. 6 children. Again, the same procedure we will follow. Okay? First, we will distribute 1 to each, and then if the apples left, then we will go for the second round. This is for this boy, girl. Again this one. Yes, we will distribute 1. Okay, all 6 children, they received 1. Correct? Now we can start the second round. We'll see what happens. Yes, this boy got 2. Here also 2. Here also 2. This also 2 got. This boy also got 2. And this girl also got 2. Yes. Here also we can see the equal distribution of 12 apples among 6 children. Yes, how many each one will get? Each child will get 2 apples. Isn't it? This is called division. What we did here, we distributed the thing among the children or among the people in equal proportion. Now, we will proceed to next one. See, there are 20 dots. We will arrange them in different possible ways. See here, 20 dots are there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Yes, here 20 dots are there. First, we will try to arrange them in a group of 4. Here, what is written? We will divide 20 dots in group of 4 dots. Means we are going to make the group of 4 dots. Okay, now here I will draw a table, because here 4 parts are there, 4 columns are there. If we put 1 dot in 1 column, then it becomes a group of 4. Okay, we will use these dots and we will fill this table so that we will get group of 4. See here, this is the first group, isn't it? Now, this is the second group. Here 4, 4, 8. Here 12 they became, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. Right? 20 dots, we made these dots, 20 dots in the group of 4. Yes, how many rows we got? This is first row. This we can call as second row. This is third row. This is fourth row. And this is fifth row. Means we got 5 groups. Correct? 5 groups. Each has 4 dots. So we can write, we got 5 groups of 4 dots. Means here equal distribution is done. Isn't it? Okay, now same thing, we will arrange them in different way. We will divide 20 dots in group of 5 dots. Means in one row, we need 5 dots. Okay, again table we will draw. Now I will put, these are 5 dots in one group, correct? Now again 5 dots in second group. These 5, third group, and this is fourth group. Now you know that 4 5s are 20 in multiplication, right? So this is first row, this is second row, third row, and this is fourth row, isn't it? Now can you tell me how many groups we got? Yes, in one group 5 dots are there, like that how many groups we got? Yes, very good, 4, right? We will write, we got 4 groups of 5 dots. Isn't it? See, first row, second row, third row and fourth row. Only 4 groups we got of 5 dots. I hope you understood about this, right? Now, next one. Here you can see a sum. Divide 8 envelopes in group of 4. These are called envelopes, packet. Okay, how many envelopes are there? 4, 4, 8. 8 envelopes are there. We have to divide them in a group that should contain 4 envelopes. Got this? In one group, there should be 4 envelopes. Means I will see here, I will do this. Okay, in this group only 4 are there, and in second group also there are 4, right? We will separate them. Okay, these 4, this is the first group and this is second group. You can say lot. Okay, see, we can write here, we get 2 groups of 4 envelopes. Got this, children? We are making or we are distributing the articles or whatever the things in groups or in lots. Now, here you can see there are 27 marbles. How many marbles are there? 27. Distribute among them equally among 3 children. How many does each child get? See here, how many marbles are there? 27 marbles are there. Now, how many children are there? 3. We have to distribute these 27 marbles among these 3 children, that also equally. Okay, what we will do? We will group them. Okay? Yes, 27 are there. Then you know, now one we distributed about the apple, right? Now we will not do like that. Here only we will count and we will make the group. Okay? See here, this will become the first group, that is of 9 marbles, correct? Because you know that 9 threes are 27. You know the tables, isn't it? And you know multiplication also, right? 9, when we multiply 9 3 times, we will get 27. So here we got 3 groups or 3 lots, right? First lot we will give to this girl. She got 9, isn't it? Now second one here and third to this boy. Yes, we have distributed the marbles equally. Here we can write each child will get 9 marbles. Right? If total 27 are there and if you want to distribute equally among 3 children, then each will get 9 marbles. Yes? Next sum. If 35 flowers are divided equally among 5 children. How many flowers are there? 35. You can count here. 35 flowers are there. And we have to divide them between 5 children. How many does each child get? Yes. Come on, recite table 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are, yes, 20, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 30, 5 7s are 35. Yes, here 5 children are there and 7 flowers. If we give each child, then we can distribute these 35 equally among 5 children, isn't it? Children, we will make a group of 7 flowers. We will see here. Okay, this is the first group, second group of 7 flowers, or you can say the third lot of 7 flowers. This is fourth lot and this is fifth lot. Okay, now we will give the lots to each child. Okay, one lot to one child. See, this is for first boy, this is for second one, this is for third one, this lot for this girl, and this lot for the last girl. Yes, here we can say each child got 7 flowers, or we can write that each child will get 7 flowers, isn't it? Okay, Next, yes, there are 25 chocolates. Distribute them equally among 5 children. How many does each child will get? You can see here 25 chocolates are there, right? And 5 children, we can see here 5 children, they are ready to receive the chocolates. Yes, they are eager to get the chocolates. Now come on, tell me. Again here we will make the group and then we will give these chocolate to these children. Come on, tell me. Yes. Okay, we will make a group of 5. Very good. We will make a group of 5 and we will distribute these 25 chocolate among these 5 children. Okay, we'll start. Okay, this is first group of 5 to this boy. Second lot of 5 to this girl. Third lot to this boy. And fourth lot, which has 5 chocolates, to this boy. And fifth to the last boy. For these children, means here, each child will get 5 chocolates. Isn't it? Yes. Next. Yes, dear children, this is from your textbook. Okay? We will try to solve this. There are 12 biscuits in a packet. Equal shares must be given to 3 children, Raju, Sanju and Anita. Yes, here we can see how many biscuits? We can see 12 biscuits. So we will write total biscuits 12. First we will write this. Okay, then each one's share. Who? Raju, Sanju and Anita. Okay, we have to distribute equally among these 3 children. Now, we know that we have to make the lots or groups. Okay, and 12 biscuits are there. Now, here we will make a group of, yes dear children, yes, group of 4 biscuits, isn't it? These 4 to this boy who is Raju, these 4 to Anita and these 4 to Sanju, isn't it? If we make like this, then we can give the equal shares, correct? Equal shares to these 3 children. So we will write here Raju's share, that is 4 biscuits, Sanju's, that is also 4 biscuits, and Anita will also get 4 biscuits, right? So here, on sharing the biscuits equally, each one got how many biscuits? Yes, very good, 4 biscuits, correct? Nice. See one more sum from your textbook. Here, mark the lots in the picture and complete the table. Now, total number of cucumbers, here 10. In each row, there are 10 cucumbers. And number of cucumbers in one lot, we have to distribute according to the lot. Okay, now total number of lots means how many lots we will get after making lots to the said quantity, we have to write here. Okay, we will go through the first row. Total number of cucumbers 10 and number of cucumbers in one lot, here 1. Okay, we will make the lots. This is second lot, third lot, fourth lot, fifth lot, sixth lot, seventh lot, eighth lot, ninth lot, this is 10th lot. Means total number of lots we got is 10. Correct? Now we will move to second row. Total number of cucumbers 10. Number of cucumbers in one lot means one group has two cucumbers. It is shown here, right? We will make next. See, this is next lot. See this. We will make a group of two cucumbers. Yes. How many lots we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Isn't it? So we will write here total number of lots 5. Now we will move to third row. Again 10 cucumbers are there and in one lot we have to keep 5 cucumbers. Okay, here we will make a group. See, this is group of 5 cucumbers. And here also 5 left. So we will make one more group or lot. So we got only 2 lots. So we will write 2 here. Now in the last one, total number of cucumbers 10. And in one lot, how many cucumbers we have to keep? 10. Yes. Come on, tell me. Yes. How many lots we will get? Yes. Correct. Only one lot. Right? Because it is said that in one lot, we have to keep 10 cucumbers. Got this? Okay. Now here, your class teacher and your people. Yes, here we can see 15 children along with their teacher. Correct? How many children are there? 15 children. Boys and girls together, they are 15. And teacher is there. Now what the teacher said? See here. Just said, make a group of 5. She asked her children to make a group of 5. She wanted to take them to the ground. Yes, so she told to make a group of 5. Yes, we will see how they will make the groups of 5. Okay. Yes. Yeah, these two girls, these two, they became 4. Yes, this boy came and joined the first group. We got one group of 5 children. Now, yes, come on children. Yes, these two came this side. Yeah, 4 they became. And one more is here only, correct? And these two came down, they came in front. Yes, yeah, they became 4 and this girl 2 joined this group. Very good. Yes, we got here 3 groups. Correct? Each group has 5 children. Very nice. Now, again, the teacher said, now make a group of 3. We will go upstairs to the laboratory. So make a group of 3. Come on. Now we will see how they will do. Yes, again. 2. These 2. These 2. Yes, she joined and this group became 3. Correct? Now these 2 here. And these 2 this side. Here, what they are doing, I don't know. Yes. Now, we can see the group of 3. Correct? Each group has 3. How many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 groups we can see. Isn't it? We can see 5 groups. Each group has 3 children. Right? Okay, very good. Teacher became very happy. She said, wow, great. You all children, you are very great. Yes, dear children, I hope you too understood about this concept. Isn't it? Making a lot or a group. Yes? Yes, teacher became happy and she told class for you all. Here we can write like this. Making equal lots from a collection of objects is called division. Right? We made lots, equal lots for equal distribution. That is nothing but division. Got this? Yes, dear children, thank you. And please go through your textbook and try to solve the sums from your textbook. Okay? We will meet in the part 2. Thank you very much, students, for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get new updated videos.